It's here. Final Cut Pro 11 is here. And honestly, this update is massive. I'm talking new tools, new features, and upgrades we've all been waiting for. Before you download it, I always say this, but it's important. Don't forget to back up your current version first. Trust me, it takes like, you know, only 2 minutes. Go to the applications folder, Final Cut Pro, compress that thing, move it to wherever you want it, and there you go. Now, there are other stuff that you can do, but let's get into these updates for now. Transcribe to captions. Yes, Apple has finally done it. They cracked the code. Yeah, you can now automatically generate captions inside Final Cut Pro for free. Yeah, for free. Just select the clips you want to transcribe, hit the magic wand icon, and choose Transcribe to Captions. And there you go. Look at that. It even works with clips that have music or sound effects layered in. No need to disable anything. Now, I know what you're wondering. Can these captions double as titles? Can we change the font, add some effects, and animate it a little bit? Well, not quite yet. And that's probably gonna take Apple about... Nah, come on, let's stay excited. We're excited. Stop that negativity. This is version 1.0 of these features. So for now, captions stay captions, and these are the options we have on the right. You will be able to change language here once it's available. You can click on these arrows to move back and forth between the captions. You can edit captions here in this box, change the format a little bit, change color. You have two options for the placement here, either up or down. Listen, social media content creators, this feature is gonna make your workflow smoother and save you tons of time. Next up, let's talk about spatial video editing. Final Cut Pro 11 now supports spatial stereo 3D videos. When you create a new project, you can switch your video format to spatial stereo 3D. Now, full disclosure, I don't have a Vision Pro yet, so I don't really have a lot to say about this feature. Did we need this feature now more than other features like a better way to animate our keyframes? Probably not, because it's not a feature that a lot of people are gonna use now. But this is the kind of forward thinking that I wanna continue to see from Apple. So let's stay excited. We're still excited. All right, now this next feature right here is one I'm really excited about. The magnetic mask. Look, I use the version in Resolve. I use the one Mroto AI used for rotoscoping because they asked me to review it. And I think this one is better than those two. Matter of fact, I'm gonna go even further. When it comes to selecting your subject, tracking and masking that subject, rotoscoping, this is the best I've ever seen so far. Here's how it works. Let's say you want to apply an effect to just one part of your footage. You can now click and drag the effect straight from the browser onto your clip. It's here with the mask and keying effects group, and the magnetic mask, once you apply it, automatically identifies your subject. Look at this. I just clicked on this subject here and it selected it. No tedious manual selections. You don't have to scribble on it. You don't have to go around it. The AI selects the subject or object for you. If it picks up unwanted areas like a background or just something that you don't want to be a part of your selection, you can quickly refine the selection. Just use the minus tool up here or hold the option key, click on the unwanted areas, and they're gone. Now in your video inspector, you can still adjust the feather. There you go. Once you're satisfied, hit Analyze here in the viewer on the left side, and the mask tracks your subject in real time, just like the object tracker does. It doesn't matter where your playhead is, it will track both ways. You need to remove a background? No problem. Just drag over the areas you want to keep, click on Analyze, wait for Final Cut Pro to track it, click Done, and boom. The background is gone. It's that easy. This opens up so many creative possibilities, and if masking was always a pain for you, this feature is gonna be a game changer. Like I said, I'm gonna have to do a dedicated video just for this one, but for now, let's dive into the new effects and transitions in Final Cut Pro 11. All right, first up, we have the new picture-in-picture effect. You can find it under Reframe. Just drag the effect into your clip And you can see in your viewer, it animates that clip into a resizable box. There is masking there going on. And you can adjust the size, position, and even add rounded corners for a circular look. You want an outline? Done. You can also change the width and color with just a few clicks, or you can just drag these on-screen handles here in the viewer. I'm gonna put this clip down here so that we can see how this is gonna look like. There you go. You can also add an overlay fill on the background, just like this, and here's the result. Not bad, not bad. Next to that effect right there is the CallOut effect. It lets you highlight specific parts of your frame. These two effects are very similar with some slight differences. This one has more parameters you can control for the background fill. As you can see here, it isolates a part of your footage and adds a blur and a dark overlay on the original footage. For what I do here on YouTube, these effects are perfect for me. I love these effects. But let's not sleep on the modular transitions. Go to the transitions tab. They should be easy to find, and we're gonna take an example here. I'm just gonna put this circle inset at the beginning of this clip, and look at how smooth that animation is. You can also create a split screen effect with these ones, side by side and top to bottom. Let's add this here. Yeah, just create it anyway, and check that out. Play around with the length of the transition to hold the split for longer or shorter. You can also adjust the position here in the video inspector to create a more dynamic flow. There are also some on-screen controls here for quick adjustments. But hey, just have fun with it, man. There are so much stuff that you can do with these transitions and all these new effects actually and these new features. All right, let's talk about some of the smaller updates in Final Cut Pro 11 really quick. What do we have here? Custom frame rates. You can now create timelines at 90, 100, or even 120 frames per second when you create your project. Just create a new project, head into your video settings, click Customs, and select the frame rate you want. Don't ask me when Adobe Premiere introduced that feature because I switched from Adobe to Final Cut Pro a long time ago. What else do we have here? If you have clips cluttering your browser but don't want to delete them, you can now right click and select hide clip. They'll still be in your project, but they're out of sight until you need them. And if you ever want to see them again, just toggle show hidden clips here. You see the clip has this icon right here on the left that tells you it's a hidden clip. Speaking of timelines, you can now move clips vertically with a simple shortcut. Just select your clip, hold Option and use the up or down arrow key. There we go. This makes organizing your layers so much faster. There were times when I had to disable the magnetic timeline when I move things around because of this, but not anymore. Here's another one, and this one's low-key fire. Usually, if I want to see my whole timeline from left to right, I just press Shift-Z, but now with Option-Shift-Z, you can see all your layers vertically at the same time, and of course, you can still scroll up and down, but it's cool to be able to see all the connected clips with that simple shortcut. They look like small changes compared to the main key features of Final Cut Pro 11, but believe me, they make a huge difference in speeding up your workflow and keeping your projects organized. And there you have it. Man, that's a lot. That's a lot. Tell me, which feature are you most excited about? I know which one is the one for me, but let me know in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe because we're gonna go deeper into these tools in the next couple of videos. See you in the next one, hopefully. Peace.